Thank you, Chiara. So, hello everyone. It's nice. I'm going to present Daniela. Daniela Barbero is a PhD candidate in the course of Environmental and Infrastructure Engineering, and she's an environmental engineer as me. So, we are both connecting this side. But Daniela is doing a PhD executive, so different from most of us, as you know, because a PhD executive means that she's an employee of a company called Arianet, which is a consultancy company in the field of environmental engineering and in particular of pollutant dispersion models. So she's working in the company, but she's doing a PhD, which means that she has, of course, a PhD topic which is involved, and this PhD topic is in the field of Lagrangian particle dispersion models. So today, Daniela is going to present her topic. So yeah, the floor is all yours.
Good afternoon to everyone, and thank you for the presentation. And so, as Angela said, I'm Daniela Barbero, and I'm in environmental engineering, and I am following an executive PhD as an employee of Arianet. Arianet works in the field of the modeling of atmospheric pollution, and it is very active in the field of research. My PhD research is focused on the so my PhD research is focused on the modeling of atmospheric dispersion of pollutant at microscale. Microscale in the field of atmospheric models means that we are considering models that are able to resolve the concentration field with a horizontal scale of some meters. And they are models that can take in account the effects of the obstacles, such as the building, on the dispersion of pollutants inside the atmosphere. These type of models are useful, for example, to do a simulation of the traffic sources inside cities. They are models that require a lot of computational resources, which means that require a lot of processor to be run, and the simulation are long. So today this talk is aimed to present a way to accelerate a microscale model using statistical techniques based on the kernel function. So, first of all, I will explain the motivation that drove my work, and then I will give you an overview of the type of model I work with, which are the Lagrangian particle dispersion models. Then I will explain the kernel method and its implementation inside the microscale model. Then I will show you some test cases, and then the first real application of the accelerated microscale model. So first of all, why microscale model? The use of this type of model is growing in the last years in different application fields. As I said before, this type of model can take in account the effects of the presence of obstacles, such as the building, on the dispersion of pollutants. So they are fundamental tools to simulate the air pollution inside cities, because in inside cities there are the buildings that strongly affect the dispersion of pollutants, causing strong inhomogeneities in the urban environment and causing local hotspots in the concentration field. Moreover, these type of models are a tool that can be useful for the planning of the urban environment, and they are also requested for the study of public health in epidemiological field. Moreover, in the last year, there is an increasing demand of this type of tool in the emergency response field. It is important to take into account the effects of the buildings if we are simulating, for example, a city, because of the strongly influence that buildings can have on the dispersion of pollutants. For example, if we are simulating the dispersion of a gas emitted by a source, if we don't take into account the effects of buildings, as we see on the left, we can see the wind field, which is not affected by the buildings, and the mean wind goes from the northwest to southeast, and so the pollutant is spread in the same direction. Instead, if we take into account the effects of buildings, we see that the wind field is completely different and the pollutant is spread in the opposite direction. So if we are working, for example, with the firemen, and this is a release of a toxic gas, we are able to indicate the most impacted areas with more precision. At micro scale, we can use two type of models, the computational fluid dynamics models and the Lagrangian particle dispersion models at micro scale. Both these type of models request a lot of computational resources, and the simulation done with both of these type of models are long. Now I will give you an overview of the Lagrangian particle dispersion models, and then I will explain why I choose this type of model and I don't use the computational fluid dynamics models, even if these type of models are in general more accurate from the point of view of the physics implemented in the model. So, Lagrangian dispersion particle models simulate the dispersion of pollutants following the trajectories of a large number of particles, virtual particles, that are spread into a three-dimensional domain. It is important to underline that these particles are not real particles of pollutants, but they are computational particles used inside the simulation, and each of the particles is associated to a fixed amount of mass of the pollutant. So the Lagrangian particle dispersion models take as input a three-dimensional meteorological field. For example, we see a wind field, and then particles are spread into the domain, and each particle is moved independently and based on the wind provided by the meteorological model that can vary in time and space. And then the motion of each particle is influenced also by a stochastic component which represents the turbulence of the inside the atmosphere. So the Lagrangian particle models based on the spatial distribution of this particle is able to compute the concentration field at certain time, as we will see later. I choose to use the parallel MicroSwift and Spray, which is a suite, a modeling suite, and it has the two main components: the meteorological model, which is PSwift, and the effective Lagrangian particle dispersion model, which is PSpray. And the Lagrangian particle dispersion model is driven by the wind field, the meteorological field given by PSwift, that is able to take in account the effects of the buildings, as we see, over the meteorological variables. So, why I choose a Lagrangian particle dispersion model and not a computational fluid dynamic model? First of all, the meteorological part that drives the motion of the particles is a simplified computational fluid dynamic model, and we verified that the results that we obtain in a urban environment with the PSpray model are of the same quality of the results obtained with some of the computational fluid dynamics models. Moreover, the use of PSpray can give us the possibility to deal with large simulations, because the Lagrangian particle dispersion models require less time and less resources relative to the computational fluid dynamics models. So we preferred to use this type of model. Even if we use a Lagrangian particle dispersion model, the constraint of time remains. The time requested by a simulation done with this type of model is strictly related to the number of particles emitted during the whole simulation. In fact, fewer particles we emitted, faster is the simulation. But the number of particles emitted strongly influences also the quality of the results. So if we use a number of particles which is not high enough, the quality of the results of the concentration field are bad, and as we see, the concentration field is less smooth and also is less statistically reliable. This happens because of the way we compute the concentration field inside the model. In order to compute the concentration field, the 3-dimensional domain is subdivided into three-dimensional cells and using a regular grid. Inside of each cell, is taking into account the position of the particles at a certain time, and it is used a method to compute the concentration, which is called the box counting method. It consists in counting all the particles inside a single cell in order to compute the overall mass of the pollutant inside the cell, and then this number is divided by the volume of the cell itself. In this way, we compute the concentration field all over the domain, and the problem is that if we don't have enough particles inside each cell, computation of the concentration is not reliable, and final concentration field is scattered. So we want to find a way to reduce the overall number of particles emitted during the simulation in order to reduce the simulation time, but we want to obtain the same the results with the same quality of that of this we obtain emitting an higher number of particles. So we try to use another method to compute the concentration field, and this method is called kernel method. And instead of counting the particles inside of a cell, we use a density distribution function, which is the kernel function in the three dimensional dimension. And each particle is associated to this density function, and the mass associated to the particle is count not only inside the cell, but inside all the cell that are inside the so-called volume of influence of this particle. This volume is defined by the kernel function, which are the k, and also by the bandwidth, which are the h, that define the width of the volume of influence in the three dimension. In this way, we can use less particle during the simulation, and we hope to obtain the same result of the box counting method using a lot of particles. Regarding the kernel function in literature, we can find different shape of this function, and also for the bandwidth, we have different definition in literature, and we have to find the most suitable function and bandwidth to implement this method inside the model PSPRI. The kernel method is has been already used in literature, but only with the Lagrangian particle dispersion model at local scale. We wanted to implement it at micro scale. So we have also to deal with the problem of obstacles. Inside the obstacle, inside the buildings, the concentration is zero. So the particle cannot contribute inside a cell that represents a buildings, and it also doesn't make sense that a particle can contribute in the cell that are behind the building respect to the position of the particle itself. So we have to modify the volume of influence of each particle based on its position compared to the buildings at each time step. This check can theoretically request a lot of time. So we have to check if it is suitable to implement it inside the model. Another problem that we found is strictly related to the model itself, because PSPRI is a parallelized model, which means that we can use a lot of processor to do a single simulation in order to speed up the simulation. And we use the MPI paradigm, and one way to parallelize the simulation is to divide the domain into subdomains that we call the tiles, and each one or more processor can run the simulation inside of one tile, and then all the tile communicates between each other in order to allow movement of particle from one tile to another. So the problem is related to the particles that are near the border of a tile, and if the volume of influence of this particle can go beyond the borders. So the most correct way to deal with this problem is to communicate the volume of influence of the particle of the, at the borders between the tiles the, during the communication time. But this also can request time, and can we can have a longer communication time, and so longer simulation time. And also we have a similar configuration that is the nested domain that can be used inside PSPRI, and we have the same problem in for nested domain because the particles can be near the borders. So in order to implement the method in PSPRI, we choose after some tests the B-weight Kermit function and the geometric formulation of bandwidth, which means that the bandwidths are constant and they depend on the grid step of chosen for the simulation. We also use ground reflection term for all the particles that are near the ground in order to avoid the loss of mass near the ground. And this was already explained in the literature. And then for the problem of obstacle, we decided to implement the check of the position of the particle compared to the obstacle at each time step. And then so we modify the volume of each particle at each time step, and the mass associated to the particles is distributed inside the new volume of influence. Instead, for the problems of the borders of tile or nested domains, we decided not to communicate other information between the tiles, but we treat the borders as impermeable boundaries. So we, for the particles that are near the borders, we modified the volume of influence and considering the border as an obstacle, and we redistribute the mass of the particle inside the new volume. Okay. Finally, we also used a two-dimensional kernel method in the x and y direction in order to compute the position field inside the model. So I will present you some test cases. We tested different kind of sources, point and linear sources. We tested different kind of pollutant, gaseous pollutant and particulate, and for the particulate pollutant we also computed the deposition, and we tested the different configuration, both the tile configuration and the nested configuration of the domain. As I said before, our goal is to obtain concentration field and deposition field of the same quality of these computed with the box counting method with a large number of particles. So we used to compare our results, we used the results of the same simulation driven with the box counting method. And we use two statistical indexes, the fraction of two and the index of agreement. So the first test cases consider our point sources and that emit gas, a gaseous pollutant. And we can see the comparison of the hourly ground concentration field computed with the box counting method and the kernel method. And with the kernel method, we use the 20% particles that we used in the box count, the simulation driven with the box counting method. The statistical indexes that we computed are Eig, and the field, the results are very similar, and we also obtain a time reduction of 70%. And this is a tile configuration, so we see that at the borders of the tile, we have the field is less comparable to the field of the box counting method, but we are satisfied with these results because the communication time cannot be longer. So the second test case consider a nested configuration of the domain. They have a different horizontal resolution. The domain inside has an horizontal resolution of 1 meter, and while the domain outside has a horizontal resolution of 2 meters. And source that we are considering is a PowerPoint source, and it emits both gaseous pollutant and particulate pollutant. So we computed the concentration of both pollutant, and then we computed also the deposition of the particulate pollutant. Also in this case, we are looking at the hourly ground concentration field. We computed with the box counting method and the kernel method. The position field will be very similar to this. So even in this case, we obtain a good performance. The two fields are very similar, and the statistical indexes are near the ideal values. In this case, we obtain an higher reduction of time, even if we use the same particle reduction. This is explained by the fact that the previous case, the communication time is higher because we have six tiles that have to communicate between each other. So in this case, we have only two domains that have to communicate to each other. So the communication time, which is a fixed amount of time compared to the simulation time, the overall simulation time is higher. So the kernel method cannot give results on the communication time. So the third test case consider instead some linear sources. In this case are the traffic sources in the city of Milan. We can see in white it is the central station of Milan. And we compute all the traffic sources with an horizontal resolution of 4 meters. And we used a tiled configuration, and we emitted a gaseous pollutant. Even in this case, we obtain similar fields. I underline that they are hourly ground concentration field, and that are our target, because the law request compute the hourly values in order to compute some statistical values in order to verify if the quality of the air is good enough. So even in this case, we have the same time reduction of the case before, which is an 80% time reduction. Then after the tests, we use the PSPRI model with the kernel method in a real simulation. This simulation was done inside the LIB project, which was an Italian research project in the epidemiological field. We were requested to compute an annual simulation over the entire city of Rome of all the traffic sources, because this simulation would be used as input of the epidemiological study. So we had to simulate all the traffic sources inside Rome in a three-dimensional domain of larger 12 per 12 square kilometers with an horizontal resolution of 4 meters. And clearly, we have a lot of linear traffic sources. So we estimate that this simulation was not feasible with the standard PSPRI model, because we estimated that it would take 10 months on a high performance computer system with 180 processors, and so it was not feasible, and it would cost too much. So we used the PSPRI model with the kernel method, and we were able to compute the overall simulation. The annual simulation means that we compute all of the hourly concentration field during the whole year, and this simulation took 46 days on the same performance computing system. So it was feasible, and it was faster enough to give the results to the epidemiological group in time. So we used a tiled configuration, and this picture we can see the annual mean of dioxide. Then I will show some results, some comparison with measurements of the simulation. In the domain we have the 7 station, monitoring station of the regional agency of the city of Rome. So we compared value measured by the station that are different kind of station with the annual mean computed with the model, and we see that we obtain very similar results for different kind of station. And instead, we also can see the comparison between the daily mean measured in black and the concentration daily mean computed by the model in red. And we see that the comparison is good. So we successfully tested the kernel method compared it to the box counting method for different kind of sources, different kind of pollutants, and we tested it to compute the concentration and the deposition fields, and we tested it for a different kind of configuration of the domain. And we were able to obtain quality of the same, we were able to obtain results of the same quality of the results obtained with the box counting method. And at the same time, we were able to obtain a strong reduction of the time of the simulation. Thank you for the attention.